Ladies and gentlemen, studying is three rounds and a catch weight bout. Introducing first, by the blue corner, weighing in under 72 kgs, by Elvis B.G. Charlestown, presenting Aiden O'Boyle.
Right, say his last name for me, because he went mad at me the last time because I said it wrong on the broadcast.
McGilligan?
Yeah, I think I might have called him McGilligan.
Yeah, I think
did
you did.
I?
Yeah.
That caused a bit
and again. Teammate of yours?
Well, he's from Strabane. Okay. He's from Strabane. He fights MMA out of Newry, so I wouldn't really see him that much.
Yeah.
But we bonded very much over at the Europeans a couple of years ago. I'm a big fan of his since then. However, I'm getting a little bit of criticism on the text line, Noel, from one of his coaches, from one of his friends. Actually, he called him his idol, not even his coach.
Oh.
So I won't
Nathan
reveal who
McGilligan
it
is 1-0, taking on 1-1. Aiden O'Boyle. O'Boyle is in the white trunks and McGillan is in the black.
And Aiden took this on like 6 days' notice, I believe. 6 or 7 days' notice. Wasn't originally meant to be faced against Nathan, from what I know.
Now Boyle coming off a big KO win at Cage Legacy recently. So momentum, a nice head kick just grazed across McGillan's face there.
That may be another fight I'm thinking of, sorry. But
looking to take the back here, and Nathan not wasting time, no hooks in yet, so he's looking to try and wrap one and sit back.
The left hook is in strong. If he falls to this side now, he'll be able to use that to open him out. Aiden's doing the right thing of keeping his hip down really low to stop Nathan from getting that second hook in, but that takedown transition towards the turtle seated position was just beautiful from Nathan. Really slick.
Some punishing shots to try and open up to get that second hook in, which he now has. Excellent work by Nathan on top, and he's now going to land punishing shots and try and steal a forearm under the chin of O'Boyle. Got to be careful as he's sitting up here. As soon as that chin even opens up a little, McGillian will try and sneak that in. But good position here, trying to escape here, potentially out the back door.
Really nice escape. And even though he had both hooks in, see when you're on your arse and the other person is just higher than you, it's such a hard thing to then try and pull somebody back down, even if you have it. It could be under. No. So good assessment of the position by Nathan in terms of maybe not falling back to his guard and taking the bottom position, fighting himself back up to get the back again.
Hugging the body as well, the position there, keeping his chest close to the back.
But Aiden's doing the right thing when he's bringing his hands down to the feet to try and get rid of one of the hooks. What I'd look for is to try and start walking the hip out at the same time. You're not just going to be able to use the hand to move it. You need to be using the hip at the same time.
It was a nice little trap there with the right leg trapping the right arm of O'Boyle. Has the feet crossed here. Going to switch their body triangle potentially when he switches hips, so he doesn't want to be on the ankle side of that triangle.
Hands are connected.
This is under. It looks on the chin, but can be excruciatingly sore. Look at the fight hands here. There's the tap. Tried to fight it momentarily.
Brilliant
but he
stuff.
Couldn't do. Beautiful finish by Nathan McGillan. And I noticed, Andrew, throughout that fight, you adopted the approach of just calling him Nathan.
I did, yeah. I made the conscious decision beforehand to avoid controversy to just call him Nathan. We wouldn't use the last name at all. Here we go, folks. The interval. We'll be back in a little while. Unfortunately, no raffle to keep us occupied here. Another downfall of this promotion that we didn't rectify from the last time. There should have been a raffle, by all accounts. I can't believe I didn't push for a raffle, to be honest. But we'll be back.